JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for July the 3rd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar was found higher against the majority of the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian morning Friday. It gained versus NOK, Euro, the Pound, SEK and the Yen in that order, while it underperformed against NZD, the Canadian dollar and the Aussie. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the Swiss franc. The fact that the main winners were the commodity-linked currencies Kiwi, Luni and Aussie, combined with the relative weakness in the safe haven yen, suggests that market sentiment remains supported for another session. Indeed, looking at the performance of equity markets, we see that major EU and US indices were a sea of green, although appetite was softer during the US session. Today, Asian bourses also traded in positive territory, with Japan's Nikkei 225 and China Shanghai Composite gaining 0.57 and 1.14% respectively. Yesterday, the main economic release may have been the US employment report for June. Non-farm payrolls rose by a record of 4.8 million, with the unemployment rate falling to 11.1% from 13.3%, while the forecast was for a slide to 12.3%. Average hourly earnings slowed to 5% year over year from 6.6%, but this is still a very high rate, which combined with the NFP number and the unemployment rate points to a strong report. The report suggests that the labor market continued to improve, but still, even with May and June seeing consecutive record job gains, the economy has a long way to go before recovering the 22 million jobs lost during March and April. The market reaction was more or less as we anticipated, namely higher equities and a lower US dollar. Yes, the dollar slid on the better than expected numbers as the improvement in risk appetite prompted investors to reduce their safe haven holdings. And as we saw in the aftermath of the coronavirus outbreak, the greenback has been acting as a safe haven. That said, the excitement did not last for long, with US indices closing on average only around 0.45% higher, and the dollar rebounding against some of its major counterparts. This may have been due to the continued surge in infected cases from the coronavirus in the US, which forced several states to halt or reverse their reopening plans. It is worth mentioning that yesterday infected cases around the globe hit a new daily record, with the US reporting more than 55,000 cases within a day for the first time since the outbreak of the virus. With all that in mind, we see decent chances for the July jobs report to paint a softer picture. The weakness in the euro and the pound may have not only been due to the aftermath rebound in the dollar, but also due to individual stories. With EU members failing to agree on a recovery fund, the common currency continued trading on the back foot, while the pound may have reversed some of the gains made on Tuesday and Wednesday due to the lack of progress in this week's talks with regards to the post-Brexit relationship between the EU and the UK. As for our view, it has not changed. We remain neutral because markets are trading in consolidative patterns, and this may have been the case due to the ongoing battle between those who, due to improving data, see a faster than previously thought economic recovery as most nations around the globe continue to ease their lockdown measures, and those who are concerned over a second round of restrictions due to the reacceleration of global infections. We prefer to wait for clearer signals in order to start considering the market's forthcoming direction. On one hand, further loosening of the restrictions may allow economies to continue to recover and thereby support further recovery in equities and other risk-linked assets. In such a case, safe havens like the dollar are likely to trade on the back foot. On the other hand, if more nations start introducing lockdown measures, this may result in a second hit to the global economy and thus force investors to reduce again their risk exposures. Namely, equities may reverse south as investors seek for shelter in safe havens. Now, as for today's events, US markets will stay closed in celebration of the Independence Day. Elsewhere, we get the final services and composite PMIs for June from the Eurozone and the UK. As always, expectations are for confirmations of the initial estimates. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.